Hello, this is Ashi from Crafting with Ashi, and welcome to this video. This is the cute little baby card we're making, so I hope you like it. Before we get started, I wanted to say that it's warmed up here in North Lincoln. It's actually the 9th of June, and it's warmed up. It's not overly warm. It's only about 23 degrees, so not hot by any stretch of the imagination, but sitting in my filming room where I film with five lights on me, it's quite warm. So I've got the windows open, so if you do hear some noise, I do apologize. Okay, so let's start stamping. Let me show you the stamp set, and this is called Wildly Adorable, and I've used it before and it is absolutely glorious. And we're going to use this little babykins here and the one that says Welcome Baby. We're going to stamp our babykins in Memento because we want to colour in using the Stamp and Blend alcohol markers. So give him a good, or her. I've made it a little her because I know two little girl babies that are being born at the moment. One's about to be born and one in a few months' time. So there's our little babykins. Now we're going to stamp our sentiment in cinnamon cider ink because it'll match everything else we do. And I'm just going to do it here. Welcome, baby. There we go. Close that up. Now I'm going to colour in my babykins, mainly using this one here, Daffodil Delight, though I will be using a little bit of cinnamon cider and the bronzing tool, as well as the ivory, flirty flamingo, and my colourless lifter. So those are the colours I'm using. So let me zoom you in a little bit. Whoop, wrong way. So you can maybe see better what's going on. So I'm going to colour in baby. I'll put some music on and fast forward, and I'll see you at the end. I'm back, so I can't, whoopsie daisy, I colored in our little rascal. Let me come out because I can see I'm still zoomed in. So now we're going to cut him out using the stitch rectangle dies, and it's this one we're going to use. So these are the stitch rectangle dies, and I wanted to show you a trick, which is why I've got the Big Shot. Well, this is the what I call the Big Boss. I wanted to show you, you can use your plates through here, just your Sizzix plates through here, your Big Shot plates in here as well. But let's first sort out our baby here. We're going to cut it out using the die. So I'm going to get a little bit of post-it note tape, and I want him to one side. I don't want the full all of him, so I'm going to cut like that. Okay, hold it down. I'm going to put this through the big boss. I'm just going to wind it quickly through. Let me bring it through here because I keep on knocking. I've got stuff at the back of my desk, and when I do it before, whoops, sorry for the shakes. I normally don't do die cutting on film, but I wanted to show you this one especially. So you're just gonna take it off and peel this off like that and get rid of that. And we're just gonna take, now you can see he's over to one side. Now I wanted him, as you can see on my original card, a bit smaller. So what I'm going to do is actually is fit this back into the die, and you can do this, it'll catch on the stitching, and you can fit it back into the die. So let's put it the right way in. We want it here to catch somewhere like that to make him smaller, and this is the way you can make your own bespoke shape. So I'll show you. Bring the big brush back, so get ready for a few jolts, I'm sorry about that, as we go through. It's just because it's a metal die going through plastic rollers. There we go. As you can see, everything is ship shape. Get rid of all of that. Get rid of that. And then, if we're lucky, we'll just pull this gently away. Pop that there, that there. Ugh, didn't want to stay up. I have tons of little bits like that. And you see, now we've got a smaller piece. Perfect. So that's one way you can do to make your pieces smaller. That's a neat trick for you. Okay, so let's start assembling. We've got here our sentiment that says, "Hello, baby." We're just going to punch it out of here with a double oval punch. Like that. Get rid of those. And now I've got all sorts of bits and bobs here. We are going to cut out the scallop bit from some cinnamon cider cardstock. So I can get rid of that too. We can stick one to the other. And let's see. Let's do that. Just like that. Okay, set that aside. We have here a ton of stuff we don't need. We have here some of the Cinnamon Cider Designer Series paper. And we're just going to use this to map this however much we want. And I think that looks fine. Just like that. So, more Tombow. And I just love this cute little lion cub costume. As you know, my mother's family are all from South Africa. And my cousin is having, his wife is having a baby. It's due very soon. So this would have been perfect card for them, except I can't trust the post home that it won't get stolen. So I'm making it here, and then I'll take a picture and send them a picture instead. That's all I can do, unfortunately. So we just cut that out quickly using the trimmer. And there we go. So now we're ready to assemble. So we've got our card base. This is Wisp Thick Basic White, standard A6 card base. That's an A4 sheet cut in half and then folded in half. And then we've got a piece here of Bumblebee, which is another of the in colours. Just love how these yellows and browns work together. They just look glorious. So there we've got that. Now we can stick this one on the top. Something like that. Just like that. And then we've got our little baby. Let's get some dimensionals for it. A welcome baby. And as you know, I'm usually very generous with my dimensionals. You don't want anything to pop off. Okay, I'm just going to put the same as last time, I think. I like it there. Welcome, baby! So, finishing touches, I have some of these. These are the In Colour Square Gems. I think they're just lovely. So we're going to use some of these. and I'm going to use one there, and then another one there, and another one there. I think I'm going to have to order more of these. I can see myself running out of certain colours, and I'm actually doing an order today, so I need to remember to put it in. So there you go, two little Barbie cards. What do you think? Do you like them? I hope you do. If you do, I'd be grateful if you could give it a thumbs up so YouTube know. It really helps to make my videos more visible and helps with all the algorithms and all that sort of geeky stuff. And I'd also appreciate it if you're not subscribed, if you'd like to subscribe to my videos. So thank you. If you want information about this project, you know, the supply list, measurements, all that good stuff, it's on the blog post. And that's on my website. And the links to that and all my social media links are in the description box below. And that actually includes a link to my Facebook group, where I host a monthly online card club. And I've also started to, just from beginning of July, I'm also starting to host a monthly, well, it's going to be two monthly, kit club, where we make one of the Stampin' Up! Kits together. And we do it via Zoom, so we can craft and chat and have a great time, a bit like a crop. So please do come and check us out. So thank you again, and until next time, enjoy being creative. Bye bye.